Hey folks, this is a modification on my Alaska chainsaw mill rail system. I was cutting the other day and I had a problem where I had put this bracket on the bottom of my rails and it was sitting a little bit too high on the top of the log. So I realized I have to actually nip this out here. Once I have that cut out and it'll sit flush here, it'll give me a lot better fit. So I'm just going to take zip disc and make this simple modification here. I'll make my initial cut here just with the chop saw. That's pretty good. Now I just have to take my zip disc and cut this here. One piece, and then I'll just clean that up with a bit more of the grinder here. So. Okay, got both of them cut out. The intent of that mod is to put this back here done. Once I've ground that little bit off there. So we'll go next door to the grinder. That grinding stone's no good. So, we'll go to the other grinder. All right. Yeah, this stone's got a way better profile on it. Jeez, that switch is not in pretty good shape. That's good enough. Look at this. This is how you put a bolt in through a hole underneath. Right here. The magnet holds the bolt, it also holds the washer. You probably didn't know. Thank you. there's my modification to my rail now. Just sitting under here, I don't take up anywhere near as much. Won't be sitting high on the log on me. There was one other issue I had though. I've got two holes here. They're about 3 inches apart. I think I might need actually two more closer. So I have, depending on the profile of the log, right? I don't have a lot of room there. Okay. Okay, finish this small mod to the chainsaw mill rail. It's gonna work. There's always something I find, and like I say, I think I'm gonna add a couple more holes right there, but that's all I need for now. Over and out. Project time again. These are my rails for my Alaskan chainsaw mill. The end bracket that I have, I don't really have a proper way of positioning it so that I have adjustment on it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this flat bar, I'm going to cut it. I'm going to create a tab here on the outside. And I'm going to cut a piece of this guy, so like so, so that my rail will sit between them with just enough play, of course. And then I'll put a set screw here that will clamp the rail between this outer tab and that. You see, that will give me the ability to adjust to any position on that, and then just tighten it and hold it in place. You'll see once I get her done here what I'm talking about. So first thing, three and three quarters. Safety first, get the earplugs, safety glasses. Set screws to go. I'm using 5/16 bolts, so which is right here. So I want to go up a couple sizes to make sure I got good clearance. So this is 23/64. That should give me enough play. full punch of the pilot drill. Now the trick here, I have to, put my nut on like so, and there we go. So now when I tack this side, I'm centered right. These are not the nuts I'm going to use. These are not the bolts I'm going to use. Good. Okay, those can be welded. And just to show you again here, this is the idea right here. 2 inches, of course, the width of the rail. That screw will hold it. I think the first thing I'm going to do is tack weld these nuts. The Lincoln AC 225 here. 7018 rods. Just a general purpose rod. There we go. There's one set screw ready to go. Okay, number two. Thread through there perfect. That'll work. I weld that on here, so I going to do this, I guess. Get her tack welded there. And tack here. And then I'll just weld. So I got a seam along here and then here. Flat bar is 2 inches. Obviously, when I do this, I have to have enough clay that rail can slide in there. So, that'll do.
comments through there okay, so.
That 2-inch spacer runs through there just fine, so the aluminum rail should also. Got my welding done, and now what I got to do is see how this is going to work. Rails. The idea is that I have infinite adjustability for the length of my log. It's fit in there pretty good. Like that's good, and that'll work with my 20-foot rails also. Guess I don't need these anymore. Yellow. Yeah, I really like that. One other thing I really ought to do, the center brace that I have, I really should, really need to make a second one of those for my 20 footers so that they're braced every, 5 feet roughly. These are 10 foot rails, so of course that's at the 5 foot mark, that's halfway. And it just occurred to me, since I, my intention was that this would be the outside of the end piece, but if I, like I was talking about putting other holes up there, but I mean, common sense would say I should just make this my starting piece, because I can extend my rails out so that, right like that right there, my bill comes in with a straight shot here. Here was the other question. Does my mill fit outside these? And yeah, clears them easily up, so we're good. I knew it would, of course. These being just a 1/4-inch thick, but that's a pretty robust outside piece on there. It's not going to go anywhere. And you don't need immense force here anyway. Just that little snug I gave those is all it needs. There you go. Boom. Yeah, that's definitely the answer. Infinitely adjustable. So that concludes my little modification to my bracket for my Alaskan chainsaw rails. Beautiful. So I finished 2 welding jobs today. Got this Alaskan chainsaw mill rail bracket done. And I also had to fix this guy. That bracket had
broken on me, the welds let go. When we went to Alaska in 2018, I just did a real quick job on it. So today, you know, it was more or less just tacked together. So I re-welded this, all this bracket here. And then this time, instead of welding it to this is just light angle, I decided to bolt it on. A lot simpler and actually stronger than the light weld I would get here. Easier to change it in the future anyway. Yep. That was today's project. Tomorrow, crossbow. Looking forward to that. Okay. We're done here.